are big fans of the North from Fractal Design here at Robeytech. What is not to love? On top of absolutely stunning builds inside of this case, it's refined, it's minimalistic, and it performs well in our thermal testing. Plus, I mean, it's IKEA sponsored. Okay, maybe not, but come on, this thing should be at IKEA. So when we heard that the North was getting biggie sized, we knew that we were in for a treat. If you're a fan of artsy PC cases with slightly less wood than a 1983 Oldsmobile Firenza Cruiser, you're gonna wanna stick around as we tell you everything you need to know about the Fractal North XL. And it happens right here, right now on Robeytech. When we look back at 2023, the North from Fractal Design was one of the most popular cases we covered here on the channel. Not only did we receive a ton of positive feedback on our review video, which you can check out right here, as well as the streams that we did, but some of you shared that you loved the case so much that you bought it yourself. And you guys bought a lot of these cases. We even had one user on YouTube by the name of Rusio7 comment, "I hope they make an XL version of it," referring to the Fractal North. Well, YouTube commenter Rusio7, I guess Fractal Design found you, listened to you. So if this case is good or bad, we're gonna hold you personally responsible for this PC case. No pressure. Okay, I'm kidding. But what I'm not gonna kid about is just how XL they made this version of the North. Let me just say, Fractal Design did not play around. The North XL measures about 19.8 inches or 503 millimeters long, 9.45 inches or 240 millimeters wide, and 20 inches or 509 millimeters tall. For those of you wondering just how much bigger the XL is than compared to the original North, it's about 36% larger. The North XL is available in two variants, the North XL Mesh and the North Glass XL TG or tempered glass. Both versions are available in charcoal black with walnut wood panels or chalk white with oak wood panels. And get this, they cost the exact same price. So there's no upcharge for white components or tempered glass. All Fractal Design North XL cases cost $179.99. And to that we say, thank you to Fractal for keeping things simple, just like how simple the actual case looks as well. Speaking of simple, they did the same thing with the North XL's case I/O controls as well. On the top of the case, the XL has two USB 3.0 ports, one USB 3.1 Gen 2 Type-C port, as well as a power button and split HD audio jack. It's looking to us like USB 3 ports are becoming more common on many new cases, to which we say, we just wish they were just a tad bit faster. Now, as far as weight goes, the North XL Mesh and Tempered Glass XL weigh around 26 pounds, 11.9 kilograms for the XL Mesh and 11.7 kilograms for the Tempered Glass XL. For comparison, 26 pounds is approximately the same weight as three Gibson Les Paul electric guitars, or the amount of bananas you would need to make 33.57 loaves of banana bread. That's nuts. Or at least the recipe for those 33.57 loaves of banana bread called for extra nuts. Okay, back to the Fractal Design North XL. As you look inside of the XL, there is a crazy amount of real estate to work with. The case can support micro ATX, mini ATX, and ATX motherboards, as well as the girthiest EATX motherboards. Now I know what you're thinking, Robey, we've seen other cases that say they can fit an EATX motherboard. But to that, I would ask, have you ever seen one that accommodates motherboards up to 330 millimeters or nearly 13 inches wide? The answer is nay. Even cases like the ProArt PA602, the ROG Hyperion, and even the Evo XL can't handle boards that big. To make this space work even better for those generously sized motherboards, Fractal Design has added additional standoff screw mounts as well as a secondary cableway. Speaking of cableways, if you haven't seen this, this is where cables go. The North XL cases have 9 major ones. 2 of them are located at the top of the case, 3 of them are located on the PSU shroud, and 4 are located to the right of the motherboard tray. While the 3 cableways at the bottom of the case are open, all of the others have rubber grommets to help keep cables hidden. Ding! Thank you very much. As for GPU support, the North XL cases have support for graphics cards up to 413 millimeters or 17.32 inches. That's enough space to accommodate larger GPUs with almost space left to set your mug inside of your PC. There is nothing, and I repeat nothing, like warming your coffee while you're benchmarking, you know, running your Cyberpunk, just heating up your cup of Joe. But you probably shouldn't be doing coffee and PC components together So maybe that's not a good idea. Now, what does mix is you slapping that subscribe button, whipping that like button, and ringing the notification bell so that you don't miss in-depth and full of humor reviews like this of both PC parts, laptops, cases, how-to guides, and live streams where we build custom PC cases like when we do builds like this, or even give them away. Now, Robey, let's talk about the cooling. This case is pretty, but that means nothing if the thing is a giant wood-paneled air fryer. On a side note, this is what we used to call our family's 1983 Oldsmobile Firenze Cruiser after the AC blew out. That is a different story and a really crappy summer vacation. Now, for cooling support, the North XL can fit radiators up to 420 millimeters in the front and up to 360 or 280 millimeters at the top of the case. As far as depth for tower-style air coolers, the North XL has a max clearance of 185 millimeters in the tempered glass version and 155 millimeters in the mesh. While this does disqualify bigger coolers like the Cooler Master MA824 or Noctua's DH15 in the North XL mesh, equally powerful air coolers like the Corsair A115 will work just fine. We'll explain why it has a slightly different allowance for coolers in just a second. As for fan support, the XL supports three 120 millimeter or 140 millimeter fans in the front of the case. You can do one 120 or 140 millimeter fan in the case rear and either three 120 millimeter or two 140 millimeter or two 160 millimeter fans at the top. Now the XL does come with three 140 millimeter Aspect 14 PWM fans pre-installed in the front of the case. And as you'll see in a bit, they do very well for themselves. Now, if we look at the North XL mesh, it offers bonus space when it comes to fan mounting options. Fractal Design includes a bracket that sits right inside of the case with mounts for two 120 millimeter or two 140 millimeter fans. This bracket will sit in one of two strategic positions, either right in front of the CPU or right in front of the GPU. Now you can see why the mesh puts limits on the CPU cooler. While Fractal Design doesn't provide an exact measurement for supported GPU width when the bracket is installed, the 155 millimeter limit for CPU coolers is probably a good measurement to go off of. Moving on to space for storage, the North XL has two drive trays as well as two drive brackets. These two drive trays are located near the front of the case and can support either one 3.5-inch hard drive or two 2.5-inch SSDs per tray. The drive brackets only support SSDs and they can be found on the back of the motherboard tray. As for PSUs, the Fractal Design North XL can support power supplies up to 175 millimeters in length, or if you remove those drive trays, it can support PSUs up to 290 millimeters in length. Now, I do have to call this out before we move on, but the connections for the front panel are not a unified connector like we'd expect to see in modern cases. I don't know why we're still seeing this in 2024, but here we are. Fractal, can we please, please move to a single front panel connector? These hands weren't made for tiny cables like this. Okay, we can move on. Now that we know more about the space in the North XL, it's time to talk about thermal performance. Let's look at AIO cooling first. And then because this case has front air intake, we're gonna look at the thermal performance with a tower style air cooler. Here's what we discovered using an AIO. When idling, the XL mesh averaged 25 degrees Celsius on the CPU and 29 degrees Celsius on the GPU, while the tempered glass XL averaged 24 degrees on the CPU and 34 degrees on the GPU. When we look at comparisons with other cases, the CPU temps on both cases fall ahead of cases like the Antec C8, the Fantex NVA7, and of course, Li & Li's O11 Evo. The GPU temps, on the other hand, they were closer matched to the Antec P20. Under full CPU load, both versions of the North XL case remained remarkably cool, with the CPU temps with the XL mesh averaging 72 degrees Celsius, while the tempered glass XL kept things even cooler at 71. What's amazing about both temperatures is that this puts cases like the NZXT H6 on notice. Now in our 1440p gaming benchmarks, both Fractal North XL cases had a little bit more competition, including each other. Both the XL mesh and the tempered glass XL had CPU average temps of 45 degrees Celsius and GPU temps of 58 degrees Celsius. Those temperatures positioned the XL mesh in between the Antec C8 and the Li & Li O11 Evo RGB. As for the tempered glass XL, it was on the cooler side of the Evo RGB, but slightly warmer than the Asus ProArt PA602. Now, when we look at air coolers, the XL story gets even better. At idle, the XL mesh averaged 25 degrees Celsius on the CPU and 35 degrees Celsius on the GPU. The tempered glass XL was on the warmer end of 25, but its GPU averaged 34 degrees. We compared that to other cases. These two measured in at 2 whole degrees cooler on the CPU than the NZXT H6 Flow, which has been one of the coolest cases we have seen to date. Under full CPU load, the story is again very similar. The XL Mesh averaged 76 degrees Celsius, while the Tempered Glass XL averaged 77. These both bested the H6 again, which averaged 78 degrees, and the non-XL North, which averaged 80 degrees. In gaming, the Tempered Glass and Mesh XL swap places, with the Tempered Glass XL taking the lead at 46 degrees on the CPU, while the Mesh XL averaging 47. The H6 was very close to tying with the XL Mesh, but the XL was just a little bit cooler. Overall, it's amazing to see these cases and the competition they have at this level. Now, as we start wrapping this review up, we want to share a few observations and considerations with you, especially if you're looking at the Fractal Design North XL being your next PC case. Thing number one, as you're opening this case, there is an additional panel next to either the aerated or tempered glass panel that you will want to be very mindful of. This small panel is removable and actually necessary to remove when you're doing your build. But we notice that there is a little bit of play with the structure of the case around this plate. It is possible that this was a quality control issue that only impacted our unit, but it is something worth bringing up. Just be careful not to bend it. Thing number two, this case is actually cooler agnostic, which is great news. And as long as you can fit your air cooler of choice inside, you're good to go. Both AIOs and tower style air coolers thrived inside of the North XL cases, but we do have recommendations if you're torn on which to use with what cooler. If you want to use an AIO, we would recommend the Tempered Glass North XL. For tower style coolers, mesh was the all around better option. The one caveat here is that the extra bracket in the mesh does add a way to supply more air to your GPU in the absence of bottom air intake, which is a nice option. That is if your GPU isn't too wide. But honestly, none of the tests shows that the GPU were ever in danger from high heat, and both cases perform so close to each other that we could recommend whatever here. Honestly, they both really work, but we love to give you some sort of recommendation. The one word of consideration that we would share on this is simply to make sure that your tower style air cooler of choice has enough room to fit in the case. That's the only kind of difficult thing to try and fit into here. At the end of the day, if you were a fan of the Fractal North, the North XL is the North, but bigger and better. These cases are spacious, well-built, and they're such pretty cases to look at, and you can make such incredible builds. Not only do we love that the XL can accommodate just about any modern component, but we also love that it works for both AIOs and air coolers as well. With all of that considered, if you're looking for a PC case that can perform well in most of the thermal conditions and the woody aesthetic is your vibe, you really cannot go wrong with the Fractal North XL. As we wrap this up, we want to give a huge shout out to Fractal Design for letting us check out the Fractal North XL. But we want to know what you think about it. Are you excited to see a bigger version of this case? What stood out the most about this case? And if you were going to do a build, I'd love to know what theme you were going to do around it. Let us know all that down in the comments below. Now, while you're down there, go ahead and slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring the notification bell so that you get a notification each and every time we post videos like this right here on Robeytech. Also, if you have questions about the case or you want to talk about builds to put inside of it, head on over to our Discord server, discord.gg/Robeytech, an incredible place to talk to other like-minded people who love to help you figure out what would be the best Fractal North build that you can do. And you know what? You might just make a friend. Also, make sure that you follow us on all the other social platforms at Robeytech, absolutely everywhere. Thank you so much for watching this video, and we look forward to seeing you on the next one.